Okay, this is a roll of liner, 25 feet long, for a wood stove. In order to pull it down the chimney, which is got a bit of a bend in it, we've got a cone for it, a nose cone. On the other end of the nose cone, we have a rubber ball, which helps get around the bend. Over here, we have some other supplies. This is called a two-part T. And at the bottom of the chimney, we finish it off with that. That's a top finish here, rain cap, and chimney top flashing. Keeps the water out of the top. Notice the big rain cap, we always get the big size so that it's got much more protection from rain going down into that chimney. Some guys will give you the cheap one. Here's an adapter that goes from flex to the two-part T. Here's a couple extra pieces we got in case we need them. If we need them, we will have them here and not have to drive 20 miles somewhere else. So that's what they're here for. Always have to have extra parts. So we'll show you when we put this in. So here's the A connector going on the bottom of the flex. And why the A connector is there is because it gives a look, it's got these little drain holes. So if creosote goes down that flex, it doesn't drain out into the cavity, it drains back into the system through those drain holes and back into the stove where it's harmlessly burnt up. So that's an A connector. Always use that. So here's the two-part T on the bottom of the A connector. And as you can see, any creosote that happens to come down the chimney always goes on the inside. This is the bottom, and the males all go down, which allows it to go back to the chimney, into the stove, where it's harmlessly burnt, rather than kicking around the outside of the pipe somewhere and nobody knowing about it. Males down, that's the key to chimney liners and pipe.